You love puzzles, right? So here you go. What can travel through solids without making holes? What can travel and bounce and cannot be seen? What is that you make but cannot see? It is sound. We learned that sound is another form of energy. Vibrating objects create disturbance in the air and we hear sound. Sound needs a medium to travel. It can travel through solids, liquids, and gases. The disturbance of movement due to a sound is like a wave. In order to describe waves, we looked at its properties like period, frequency, amplitude, wavelength, and speed. Sound can be very loud, or it can be very soothing. We discussed the pitch of sound and how loudness of the sound can be measured in decibel scale. So let's explore some other areas of sound. Let me take this wooden stick and hit it against the wooden block. What will happen? Sound will come when I hit it. Let me take this metal strip and do the same thing. Will the sound be the same this time? No, it is a different sound. If you look at this end closely, it continues to vibrate after I hit it. I can hear a little sound if I take it closer to my ears. Vibrations create disturbance in the medium. This disturbance or movement reaches our ears and we hear it as sound. Have you seen this before? These are called tuning forks. There is some number written on each. We will see later what its significance is. It has two prongs and a common base. It is also called a stem. It is usually made of steel. What will happen if I strike these prongs against this hard rubber block? These will vibrate just like metal strip we saw earlier. Why is it called a tuning fork? When the tuning fork vibrates, it generates sound. Each tuning fork generates a unique sound. The number on the fork indicates the frequency of sound it generates. These can be used to tune musical instruments. These tuning forks have different numbers written on them. This one is 256 Hz. This one is 320 Hz. This one is 426 Hz. This one is 512 Hz. This one is 341 Hz. Can we hear the tuning fork with values greater than 20,000 Hz? Discuss with your friends and find out. Right now, I have to take this fork near my ears to listen. What can we do to make it louder? Will hitting it hard help? Will it increase the frequency or amplitude? Frequency does not increase, but amplitude does. This is an empty cardboard box. If I place the fork on the box, suddenly it becomes audible. Why? Air in the box also vibrates as per tuning fork. This results in more air vibrating overall and we hear a better sound. Box acts as an amplifier. It amplifies generated sound. Let us closely look at the movement of the tuning fork. Our action of hitting the fork sets the prong into vibrations. It swings in both directions due to its elastic nature. Its to and fro movement also moves the air around it accordingly. When it moves to the right, air around it gets compressed a bit. When it moves to the left, air spreads out and becomes thin. This continues at a constant rate. This action results in the creation of high pressure zone and low pressure zone in the air. Pattern of compression, that is region of thick air, and rarefaction, that is region of thin air, is formed. This is a disturbance in the air. Does air particle move all the way from the tuning fork to our ears? No. It is the energy that is transmitted. Air particle moves right and left just like the prongs of the fork. Kinetic energy of air particles is converted into sound energy. If prongs vibrate at different rates, air particles will also vibrate at those rates. Air particles in all directions around the prong vibrate. That is why we hear sound in all directions. Just like we plotted movement of water particles, when we discuss the period of wave, we can also draw a graph of air particle. If we plot its movement from rest position on y-axis and time on x-axis, we get a graph something like this. It is very similar to the one we got earlier. But there is one difference in which wave traveled in water and air. Can you think of what it is? In the case of water particles, its movement was perpendicular to the direction of propagation. In the case of air, it is parallel to the direction of the wave. When particles in the medium move perpendicular to the direction of the wave, it is called a transverse wave. When particles in the medium move parallel to the direction of the wave, it is called longitudinal wave. Summary: vibrations create disturbance in the medium. This disturbance or movement reaches our ears and we hear it as sound. Each tuning fork generates a unique sound. When particles in the medium move perpendicular to the direction of the wave, it is called a transverse wave. When particles in the medium move parallel to the direction of the wave, it is called longitudinal wave.